Well, now it's clear. I've just come back from the House of Representatives chamber to deliver the budget reply, and the battle lines have well and truly been drawn. On the one hand, there's the Labor government, whose budget is totally reliant on a great big new tax on mining. On the other hand, there's the Coalition, which will oppose this tax tooth and nail. Labor needs the tax to fund its continued addiction to spending. We won't accept this tax, and we will work our way back to surplus the right way, by reforming our economy and by cutting our spending. As I made clear tonight, the Coalition believes in lower taxes, smaller government, and greater freedom.
Lower taxes, smaller government, greater freedom. Lower taxes. The Howard Liberal government put in around 150 new or raised old existing taxes. Smaller government. Last time the Liberals told us they were going to cut government jobs through natural attrition, they said 3,000 jobs would be cut. It turned out to be 30,000 jobs. This time they're saying 6,000 jobs will be cut. That, as Tony would put it, is absolute crap. Add another zero to that figure and you have the truth. So let's make that around 60,000 jobs will be cut, while our unemployment still sits at around 5%. And if there is any further pain in the world economy, the effects on Australia, those jobs will be needed. Greater freedom. Tony has to be kidding. It is because of his wars in Afghanistan and the illegal war in Iraq, he's screwed our freedoms in this country, such as being able to hold people without charge in prison. Liberals are on the record agreeing with torture done by the USA, which included rape and torture of children to make their parents talk. How will the Liberals get us out of debt? They're going to have a sale, and Medibank Private is up for grabs. We all know that Telstra had been nothing but one big screw-up since the Liberals sold it, and the investors were the ones that got screwed. All these years later, and Telstra is still a nightmare for the poor suckers that believed the Liberal government and brought into the conjob. How the hell can Tony be trusted to sell Medibank Private? Simple answer is, he can't. So out of the budget reply speech, what did we find out about Tony and the Liberal Party? We found out that he can't come up with his own policy. He's doing exactly what the Howard government did. Cut jobs, sell assets, give you another form of work choices, and everything else is a me too on Labor policy, such as acting on climate change that he doesn't believe in, and maternity leave that he is on the record of saying would come in over the Liberal Party's dead body. And that is exactly what we need to do. Leave the Liberals to rot in opposition, where they belong.